Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. Another very important worldwide broadcast today on this 6th day of November, this Friday edition, the 6th day of November, 2009. We're going to have wide open phones throughout the first half, at least, of this syndicated radio broadcast so that people can chime in with their take on the very inconsistent, very suspicious news coverage on the massacre at Fort Hood, Texas, just about 75 miles from where I sit here in Austin, Texas. Fort Hood, the biggest military base in the world, the biggest U.S. military base, obviously as well, a giant army base that's got underground bunkers in the mountain range, underground railways, spurs going out all over the nation. One comes out underneath Bergstrom Airport here in Austin, formerly SAC Command Base. That's a little inside baseball for folks that don't know about that. This is complete spook central, black ops central, mind control central. They trained the Delta Force for the Waco massacre there, according to congressional documents. And we just continue to see all sorts of chicanery coming out of Fort Hood. It's geographically 6 times bigger than Dallas, Texas. It's the main base is 340 square miles, but then there's a bunch of other spur bases off of it. I mean, it's just deep in the heart of Texas. Obviously, our prayers go out to the 12 dead, 31 wounded. I wonder if they'll call for gun bans on base. You know, ban the military from owning guns. I mean, that's the answer for the citizens. This guy was a psychiatrist. He was involved in Homeland Security drills. A lot of witnesses said they saw two other shooters shooting people. It's always the same with Columbine and 7-7, all these events. It has the same MO. We know Columbine was staged. We know 7-7 was staged. We know 1993 was staged. That's even been in the New York Times. I don't know if this was staged. This guy's a psychiatrist. They have the highest level of any profession of suicide. They have the highest level of any profession of being committed. These are people that think all of the public has a chemical imbalance and needs to be on Ritalin and Prozac. I will bet all the tea in India that this guy was self-medicating as a psychiatrist. He wasn't just a psychologist. He had a medical degree in quackery. Okay? And no, I'm not saying there isn't some true information in psychiatry and psychology. It's just that the different schools and the way the government brings it forward, it's become a tool of oppression. And it's just, it is a fake science to tell a kid, you're not bouncing off the walls because you're drinking sugar filled with red dye and not getting proper nutrients. Let's not give you a good diet. Let's put you on a chemical weapon. That's what the serotonin reuptake inhibitors are. I mean, yeah, there are a lot of snake bites that as you're dying, you kind of have a rush of exhilaration at the end of it. There's a lot of poison that feels good. Methamphetamine, total poison. Morons use it. But the issue here is they're putting our kids on Ritalin, Prozac, all these other drugs. They've got millions of the troops on it. You know, millions of veterans are on it, and it is on the drug insert that'll make you have a psychotic break under stress and start killing people. I mean, this is what it does, and none of the media is talking about this. I have not seen anyone, including my writers. I'm not bashing my writers. I just wonder how everybody missed this. I'll guarantee you he's a Prozac head. Guaranteed.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
All right, we have three extremely important guests coming on today. Very important issues. We've got Chris Freiberg from Fairbanks Daily News Miner, mainstream newspaper, coming on about the Army out arresting people and tasering people on civilian highways. Just another example of posse comitatus being flushed down the proverbial commode. We've got Bob Chapman for his weekly visit on the economy. Boy, is this a timely time to have him on. And then we have Greg Gordon, the McClatchy newspaper writer that wrote this detailed article about Goldman Sachs betting against the housing market while telling everybody that it was that everything was wonderful. So that's coming up today. We are going to take your phone calls to get your take on the massacre at Fort Hood, obviously, on the economy, on the flu, whatever you like to discuss. But please have your questions and comments ready, because I am going to attempt to try to take a lot of your phone calls here today at 1-800-259-9231. When you hear one caller become disconnected, that's your chance to call in and get involved on air. 1-800-259-9231. Okay. I know a lot of you have been watching the news, and you've seen all the conflicting reports. I don't think I've ever seen a mass shooting story that's had this many conflicting reports except for Columbine. And I've done a lot of deep research on Columbine, and we were not told the truth about what happened there. They smuggled over 120 bombs, according to CBS News, into the building. The school was more than half empty that day with the word to not go to school floating around because there was going to be a shooting the next day. There was. The principal and sheriff were meeting for lunch when all of this went on at a Subway sandwich shop down the street. Most of the witnesses reported men in black uniforms and masks shooting people, at least four shooters, not two. Harris and Kleibold made a video about how they were going to kill everybody. They worked with the school and the video production department. Their parents were both involved in secret, above top secret, black programs with NASA and the Pentagon. Both Harris and Kleibold were on serotonin reuptake inhibitors. And it was confirmed that that a SWAT team shot at least two students. That was in the Rocky Mountain Daily News. That was confirmed in police recordings that were sealed by the court. And it just goes on and on. But it's like 9/11. We know the official story's not true. That's been proven. But we don't know exactly what happened. That's the problem with an investigation. You know when you're being lied to, you just don't know what happened. Now, I will say this about what happened in Fort Hood. Number one, the media is hyping this like it is the greatest event in modern times. Though I pulled up some of the numbers, there have been scores of mass shootings at other bases. There was one killing more than eight people a few years ago at Fort Bragg, a bunch of other events. And normally when you have a mass shooting and it's really someone with combat stress, post-traumatic stress disorder, or a lot of the troops came back and shot up their families or their commanders or their subordinates because they were on, in the last 6-7 years, this experimental anti-malaria drug, which was not approved, but the Pentagon used it, and then now they've had to pull it off the market and not give it to the military because it causes psychotic breaks. Remember, we had a documentary filmmaker on, but Joe Bellinger, and he was down in South America doing shoots 24 times, and he said that he took that same antiviral drug and basically had an Apocalypse Now moment like Martin Sheen does, where he literally was having a psychotic break in his hotel room. So a lot of these mass shootings were caused by that drug alone, clearly. I've talked to people that have been on it. They say it is just like a bad acid trip or something. It is just horrible. And you give this to the Delta Force.